Hello everyone, it's John here from Winning Solutions Inc. and today I will be bringing you all another Microsoft Access Expert template walkthrough. I will be showing you where to find the template database on a website, how to download the template database demo, and how to use the demo properly. Most of our templates are not designed to be used on their own. Instead, they are designed in a way that makes it simple and smooth to integrate into an existing database that you're already using. You can also build a more robust Microsoft Access database that is built around one of our templates. If you would like to create a new database that is based off one of our templates and don't know how, or don't have the time to do so, let us know and we'd be happy to help you getting the database that 100% fits your needs. With most of our templates that we offer, there are three different versions that you can purchase: a compiled runtime version, one for internal use, and one for unlimited developer use. The compiled runtime version is a run-as-is version without the paid full version of Microsoft Access using free Access runtime from Microsoft. It can be integrated into your existing Access application, but you will not be able to make any modifications to the forms, reports, modules, etc. This option is more for those of you who don't see any need to make any customizations to the template. The internal use is a version that allows you to use or modify the databases however you wish within the organization. The unlimited developer use allows you to use the database template however you wish for any applications you develop. And it also allows you to distribute the template as part of a database you create. Winning Solutions Inc.'s templates have a strong advantage over shrink wrap software that you purchase from a store or website. With our templates, you receive the source code along with your purchase, so you are able to customize and update the database as you please. With shrink wrap software, you do not receive the source code when purchasing the software, and that means you can't update or customize the database. In our video today, we will be working with a demo version of our database template. A demo is a simple way that you can view or try out our database templates so that you can determine if you would like to purchase the database template or not. This is great for customers due to the fact that all of our sales are final. And our sales are final because we give you the source code when you purchase a template, and once we give you that source code, there's really no way you can return it. If you would like to test our demos for multiple days, you're free to do so. You just have to leave the database open so the data you entered will not be wiped. Our demos are designed so that once you close the demo, all the data entered is wiped from the database. And you have to purchase the full version if you would like to save your data that you enter. Upon downloading a demo, you have to unzip the downloaded file. And zipped files make it much easier to send and download large files over the web, so that's why we do that. Unzipping a file is very simple, though. All you have to do is extract the file so you have access to the uncompressed file. If you do not know how to do it or don't understand how to unzip a file, check out our YouTube channel and watch the How to Unzip One of Our Files video tutorial to learn this simple step. The link to that video is in the description of this video, actually. So now let us get into downloading and testing one of our own demos. All right, we're going to start off by going to our website, microsoftaccessexpert.com. On the top of the website, there is a toolbar right up here, and this is all the various ways to contact Winning Solutions Inc. And if you go over to the sidebar on the left and go under Database Templates for Sale, and then click on Database Templates List. All right, this is a view of all of our templates that we offer. And as you can see, it's broken up into categories. First one is Most Popular, second is Appointment and Scheduling, Calendars, and so on, all the way down to Database Tools and Miscellaneous Templates. Today, I will be showing you the Access Daycare Appointment Tracking Database Template. What you will need to do is download the demonstration that correctly corresponds to the version of Access your computer has. Once the file has downloaded, go ahead and open it. Next, you will need to extract that file since it is in a zipped folder. So just hit extract all. Alright, and now you'll be able to open the database without any issues. Alright, and this is just a security notice that pops up, just alerting you that this database is coming from the web and it can be potentially harmful for your computer to open, but I can assure you that this content is safe. So just go ahead and click open. Alright, so this is the daycare appointment tracking database. It's great for keeping track of all of your appointments and clientele in one spot. So the first thing we'll do is add new customer. Alright, here we can add a first and last name, or even a middle name too if you want, but I'll just do first and last. John Smith. And then a child's name, we'll do Jeffrey. Alright, and then we'll fill out an email too, sure, why not. And how about an address line? You don't have to fill out all of this, of course. I'm just going to fill out some of it just for the sake of the demonstration. Just to show you that it all works. Okay, and as you can see, you can fill out phone numbers, a picture of the customer if you want to, or a picture of the child, whatever. Notes, call history, appointment history, and payment history. Okay, so we'll just do save and close for right now. So that customer should be in the database now, and we will search for them to see if they are. Alright, here you can search by the child's name, email, whatever you want. I'll just do Smith for the last name, and then hit search. Alright, perfect. That customer that we just created is in the database, and what we can do with this is double click it to view it. So that'll view the customer form again. Here you can delete it or edit any of this information. Alright, and you can also export the search results to Excel. Okay, so what it did is just opened up a new workbook for you and pulled all that information into the workbook. Alright, the next thing we'll do is make an appointment, and to do that, go into calendar view. Okay, and it'll show today's date, June 2nd, 2016. We'll make an appointment for noon. Okay, and customer, we'll do John Smith, employee one, type, let's do individual, and location one. Keep in mind all this stuff in the Dropbox, or the drop-down boxes, you can change that information, and I'll show you how to do that later. But we can add appointment details if you want to do that here, just notes for the appointment. You can change the starting time and end time as well. And workers, you can add more workers on it. And payment information, you can add that. But for now, I'll just hit select custom color. And we'll go blue. And the reason why we do this, after I hit save and close, is so that on this calendar, it'll show up blue. And that'll make it easier to distinguish between other appointments that you might have back to back. If they're all the same color, it's kind of difficult to see where one ends and another one begins. So just make them different colors and it'll look nice and neat for you. To switch days, you can hit the left or right arrow key up top. If you want to go back a day or forward a day. And if you want a specific date, just hit up and it'll bring up this mini calendar and you can select whatever day you want to. But I'll just have it for today. Okay, so this is the daily view, and there's also a weekly view, bi-weekly, month view, and then the month day view. Okay, perfect. Alright, and we can also search the calendar by a specific employee. So if you only want to see appointments for employee one, we can select whomever we want to see up here. So employee two, there shouldn't be anything because we haven't added any appointments yet. And if we go back to employee one, there you go. All right. So next thing we'll do is search the database for those appointments now. There should just be one in the database. There might be like one or two test information in there, but you can always delete it if you want to. So we can search the database by a certain criteria, like subject, location, start date, end date, employee. We'll just do employee one. You don't have to select any of these criteria if you don't want to. You can just hit run search and it'll pull up all the appointments in the database. But I want employee one. So there you go. That's the appointment that we just created. And from here, you can double click anywhere on this and it'll view that appointment in the calendar form. You can also select view an appointment form up here. And then if you double click it, it'll bring up the appointment form and you can change whatever you want to on there. Or if you want to delete it, you can do that as well. All right, so that's pretty much it for the search function. And next we'll take a look at maintenance lookups. Okay, so what we saw earlier was location, service type, and what was the other one? It was employees, okay. So we can change, let's do location, that'll be nice and easy. We can change location to whatever we want. Ames, Iowa, sure. And we can also add locations if we want to. New York, whole state. Okay, and you can just hit close. You don't have to save it, it'll save automatically. Okay, and then we'll go back to calendar view and let's make another appointment. So if we go to location, location's one we changed. So location one got changed to Ames, Iowa. That's good. And then New York was added. Perfect. But I'm not going to make another appointment. But yeah, that's good that that worked. The next thing we'll take a look at is calendar setup. And calendar options. We can mess with any of these. This is all the calendar parameters that we can change. So the first day of the week, we can change that to Sunday. And start time for each day, we can change that to whatever we want, 8:15. Yeah, it's pretty simple. Whatever you need to do, it's pretty much in here. And calendar colors, we can change that as well. You can just hit the palette right there. And yeah, save and close. Last thing we'll take a look at is reports. Okay, if you want to print invoices, if I click this right now without putting in a date start or date end, this little pop-up box says you must input a start and end date. Okay, so let's do that. And let's do June 1st until the 15th. So a 2-week period. And we'll print invoices for that week, or for that 2-week period. Okay, and so the invoice amount is going to be $50. And you can also see other information on there as well. Because that was the appointment that we just created and it was within that time parameter, so it should show up. All right. And that's pretty much all there is to this database. I'm going to go ahead and thank you guys for taking your time to watch this Microsoft Access Expert Template walkthrough brought to you by Winning Solutions, Inc. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, please feel free to give us a like or subscribe to our YouTube channel for tons of other walkthroughs and tutorials. As always, feel free to contact us for any of your IT needs, whether it be programming needed, you want to buy a template, or need help customizing a template. Contact us whenever you like. I'm going to go ahead and post our contact information in the description below of this video. Also, you can find us on about any social media website. Feel free to follow us or like us on any of those, and have a great day.